Let's see together what is the training strategy of the WordPiece algorithm on how it performs the tokenization of a text once trained. WordPiece is a tokenization algorithm introduced by Google. It is used, for example, by BERT. To our knowledge, the code of WordPiece has not been open source. So we base our explanations on our own interpretation of the published literature. So what is the training strategy of WordPiece? Similarly to the BP algorithm, WordPiece starts by establishing an initial vocabulary composed of elementary units and then increases this vocabulary to the desired size. To build the initial vocabulary, we divide each word in the training corpus into the sequence of letters that make it up. As you can see, there is a small subtlety. We had two hashtags in front of the letters that do not start word. By keeping only one occurrence per elementary unit, we now have our initial vocabulary. We will list all the existing pairs in our corpus. Once we have this list, we will calculate a score for each of these pairs. As for the BP algorithm, we will select the pair with the highest score. Taking, for example, the first pair composed of the letters H and U. The score of a pair is simply equal to the frequency of appearance of the pair divided by the product of the frequency of appearance of the first token by the frequency of appearance of the second token. Thus, at a fixed frequency of appearance of the pair, if the subparts of the pair are very frequent in the corpus, then the score will be decreased. In our example, the pair U appears 4 times, the letter H 4 times, and the letter U 4 times. This gives us a score of 0.25. Now that we know how to calculate this score, we can do it for all pairs. We can now add to the vocabulary the pair with the highest score, after merging it, of course. And now, we can apply the same fusion to our split corpus. As you can imagine, we just have to repeat the same operations until we have the vocabulary of the desired size. Let's look at a few more steps to see the evolution of our vocabulary and also at the evolution of the length of the splits. Now that we are happy with our vocabulary, you are probably wondering how to use it to tokenize the text. Let's say we want to tokenize the word again face. WordPiece follows these rules. We will look for the longest possible token at the beginning of a word. Then, we start again on the remaining part of our word, and so on until we reach the end. And that's it, a game face is divided into 4 subtokens. This video is about to end. I hope it helps you to understand better what is behind the word WordPiece.